Howdy guys. Alright, so to get started with the radial sort, let's actually set up the problem here. So I'm just going to call this geometry node radial sort. So I want to generate a set of points that is unorganized so that we can reorganize it. So I'm going to create a circle, put it on the ZX plane like so, and I'm going to drop down an add node, and I'm going to remove all the geometry from it so we are just left with our points like so. And then I'm going to drop down a sortner. Let's do a sort node, and I'm going to set this guy to a random sort. So on the point sort here, I'm going to go to random. Now you'll see that all of our points are random. And the problem here is now if I want to try to make a curve out of this using an add node, it's all going to be randomized like so. And that's not really usable in this particular case. So that's the current issue that we are faced with. All right, so let's drop down a null node here, and let's dive into the solution. So we're going to call this null node out for sort, like so. All right, so all we need to do is drop down an attribute wrangle node, and we are going to call this node the radial sort node. And I'm going to leave it to run over points there. And I want to first get the center of all these points here. So I want to find the center. All right, so we're going to do a vector, call it center. And we're going to use the getBBBoxCenter function here. We're going to pass in the first input geometry, or 0 in this case. I then want to find the direction from the center to each point, right? That way we can pass it into a function that will actually give us back radians. And that will tell us then where we are on the circle, or in a radial fashion, right? So I'm just going to say vector dir for the direction, and we're going to normalize our vector. And we're going to pass in the center minus, actually we're going to do at P minus center. At P, remember, is the position of the current point that we're working on. We're set to run over points. And then finally we can use that direction. So if we were to actually visualize that, we can do at N is equal to dir, like so. Make sure you have your normal option turned over here for your component displays. So now you can see we have a radial direction all set up. So what we want to do is create a new attribute called F at sort val. And we are going to feed in atan2, or the result of atan2, using the dir.x and the dir.z, like so. All right, so now we've got a sort value. So you can see down here in the geometry spreadsheet, we've got a sort value. What we can do is we can then feed that into a sort node, like so. Set our point sort to by attribute, and set the sort val, and you can see now our points are organized, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if I were to pass this into an add node now, and turn it back into a circle, so now we've got our curve back. We can set the add node to closed, and we literally end up with our original geometry. Pretty cool. Alright, so that's the radial sort. So let's take a look at a practical example of using radial sort. So this is a road system network that I'm building for Houdini Engine version 2. Currently it's on my Patreon page. It will be released at some point on Udemy, CG circuit, and stuff like that, but you can follow along right now. We're about, I would say, I don't know, a quarter of the way through. We just started, and so we're building up the system, but this demonstrates how to use a really good practical use for using radial sort in real world projects. All right, so hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Thanks so much.